10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
We'll see how that goes early on in the game. Already jumping into
Prepare for battle.
No Fear is the one of the few people that TPs as Ryze is already down bottom. Ryze's Dazzle yesterday was pretty damn good, and we'll see if we can do the same today. It's a different squad. No Fear will drop a sentry early on, just making sure he can block that camp. And he'll drop a ward closer to the bounty rune. So far, the only thing that Ryze has done is place a ward in lane. The way the lanes are setting up, it is going to be what seems to be Meepo's safe lane with Ryze to help out for now. And then they're going to have the mid lane OD. And then Noya will be around this top area with Hesijo playing the Axe. And he'll be in the top lane, perhaps alone for a bit.
So he's got the Iron Talon. This is the best thing they could have done to, like, set up their Meepo for success. Dazzle babysitting the Meepo, probably trying to get him to 3. So
30 seconds to battle.
Yeah, Hesijo. Good start for him. We'll see. This game starts. I mean, this can get out of control pretty quickly, though, if they're not careful with this Meepo against this Wraith King.
Yep, definitely. So Ogre does have the Orb of Venom. He's most likely going to sit
the bottom
lane.
The battle begins.
Try to lane against Meepo. That's probably the best. Like these defensive dual lanes, trying to just like survive against the pressure of a hero like Sand King and Ogre.
Right.
So and we got that going for the middle.
Yeah, they should be able to deal some damage with the Shadow Wave. They can get some poofs off, but it's just trying to survive for Ace, get up to that clone, and start getting some jungle farm. And then after that point, it starts getting out of control. But MC's starting out mid as the Empower. Davey Knight already making sure he's 1 CS with the Astral. Gonna be an interesting matchup that, well, actually might be pretty good for MT. He's got good base damage with the Empower. While bottom lane, already small auto attacks from Ryze. It is a dual melee lane, so something to keep in mind. If they can pull and keep the creep wave in their favor, C9 might be in a good position. Already Noya up in the top lane, just trying to leech experience. Always want to fly, seems to know this, and is about to walk into him and does. Rolling Boulder is available. They do have the Wraith King with the Wraithfire Blast, but he doesn't seem too interested in actually trying to find Noya and get him out of lane. He's more interested in CS, it seems like, at this point in time.
Noya. Yep, overall, set in stone. Each team has, like, their lanes that are pretty good. This safe lane for C9 is actually very good. Dazzle completely negates the pressure that Sand King and Ogre can put out in the early levels.
Yeah. And they're doing pretty well. Ace has got 5 CS. I mean, if they can get even a little bit there and get him in a good position. Another early pause. Hopefully nothing too serious. Did Rook hit the Axe top? No, he's still in the jungle. Why do you feel the Axe starting in the jungle right now at level 2?
It's perfectly fine. I think it's better for him. It'll accelerate his game faster.
This does leave Noya top though, and that means that he can't rotate mid. But even if he does rotate mid, there's no real guarantee they get a kill, especially when skewer available for MT.
There's no real pressure if he goes mid, so it's perfectly fine for him to just leech experience in the top lane. Probably better actually.
He's gonna get ignited. There's the Burrow Strike as well. He's actually in a lot of trouble here. Shockwave neutral deny. Easy.
Alright, all planned from the very beginning of the game.
All according to plan.
Yep.
Easy, Kank. That sucks. That's gonna be so frustrating. You find the hero running out of position, and all of a sudden, just shockwave just destroys them, and you're like, why? Why does this have to happen? Ooh, maybe it's gonna find a DD room. Yeah, he's only at 3 CS, you're right, man. He's getting crushed currently. That is not great.
Yep, OD actually has very, very low base damage now.
The orbs help out, but he's not got any levels in orbs yet. He's one after to use it.
He goes closing on us three. He actually might just lane bottom still. He'll like poop it out and farm jungle side. He can actually farm it with the thousand.
Yeah, I think so. There's the clone. And all of a sudden, the jungle is now open to him. Meanwhile, empty? Is he gonna stack? Looks like he's going to. Yeah. Watch out with that courier. It's probably fine. Stack looks like it was successful. Slow-paced game, man. There's not much happening. There's really nothing going on. Let me tell you.
Right. Both teams just want to get their, you know, their basic things. They have no real intentions in roaming. Charlie's happy that their sanking has a pretty decent lane. And Cloud9 is also happy that Meepo, you know, he avoided like the danger zone, and now he's comfortable just farming his jungle.
Well, with that then, when's the first big rotation coming from either of these teams?
I feel like Axe will go lean top once he gets like level 5.
Close, actually. He's gonna have a tranquil soon too.
He'll like clear these two camps. Yep. Very good start for the Axe. He'll probably kill this camp, try and take the bounty, and we'll go back top.
And that by that point, off tranquils. Noia has been slippery and somehow reached almost level 3 out of this. Always want to fly is like trying to get to the bounty rune, but there's a good chance he doesn't get this. In fact, there's pretty much no chance. There's no chance he's getting this.
So, level 3 Earthspirit, level 5 Axe, they definitely can make a play on the Warlock up top. He doesn't have his boots yet. If they ever catch him out, they can definitely kill him.
Man, Ace has sent a clone to get the bounty rune. That's nuts. I guess it's not that crazy, but I always find that kind of play interesting. Randy's getting caught. There's going to be the call, the Battle Hunger as well. And that should bring him down with one auto attack. First blood fresh to Joe. And just as planned, as we were talking about, they rotate up the Ogre, as Joe does have Shadow Word. So Ignite and Shadow Word with Fire Blast come next. Trouble here. The call will go. Low on HP. And one more auto attack to bring him down to the Shadow Word to take a little bit of the job. So he stays a bit too long. Still not a bad trade though for C9 at the end of the day.
Yeah, definitely not. Big kill on the Wraith King. Wraith King, similar to Ventral Spirit in the aspect that he does not farm that fast. He's a very momentum-based farm.
Wraith King. That early, and you like to have him in some aggressive lanes where you have a stun available to be able to get kills. So not only is he not finding those kills, but he's also died once, as you just mentioned.
Yep, he's still sitting at top of the CS chart still. So
is Afterlife dead? Oh no, he saw Ace. Ace showed himself a bit too early. This is a pretty good start for Cloud9. Wraith Fire Blast over coming out. Yeah, Hestijo might be in some trouble. Shadow Word coming in. The Ogre's gonna come behind as well. They have Ignite. He is in trouble. Fire Blast. He has 5 stick charges. He will use his call. Won't get the stick charges off, so. Second death in a row, and now it starts to get interested. His friends get involved.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
And they even TP the shrine. They give always want to fly at the tail end of the shrine so he gets some mana back. Good start.
But so what do Cloud9 do about this top lane now? They obviously want to press the Wraith King, but it's very difficult when the heroes are around. Sand King's actually TPing to the shrine, Afterlife coming in.
They have an invis rune. Baby Knight might just be dead if he's not careful.
Oh, the courier flies through the creeps mid laner where the Magnus is.
Yeah. That's all the way up.
Radiant's top tower.
He doesn't really work out for the Sand King then.
They haven't seen Afterlife yet though, and he is going for
Hestijo's gonna walk right up. Epicenter's gonna go. Hestijo avoids it, and the Epicenter gets canceled, and so 2 minute cooldown. Okay.
That feels bad.
That's not
unlucky.
Great.
Unlucky.
It just goes the opposite direction. He's like, listen, there's a camp up here I gotta get.
Yeah, with Sixth Sense there going off, letting him know.
That's pretty hilarious. He didn't know how close he was to death, and he won't until they watch the replay or something.
Yeah. Sometimes you just get a feeling, you know, you move randomly. Oh, why am I going here? I want to farm this camp.
Yeah, exactly. That type of play is crazy.
Yeah.
It's It saves his life and allows the rest of the crew to continue to farm out.
They're set up a bit with the cult.
Yeah, there it is. They get the kill. Skewer almost bring Hestio back, but the dead body falling away as the skewer was happening. And so Hestio gets the kill, so he gets back into it. Despite dying twice top, he's now got another kill to his name. So 2-2-0.
Yep, very nice kill. They are going in on bottom, though. Can he get the stun in time?
Oh, no. Afterlife is having a rough couple of moments here. Rise makes another good TP. That's the early grave coming out. Great effect. And they've caught back up pretty well. They've got Baby Knight farming into Animitis. They have Ace, who is obviously doing well. Enough for an Ogre Club. Poofing and farming and getting good
Radiant's
CSL
bottom
across
tower
the map.
Is under
Looking
attack.
For the 8-minute bounty rune. Which
just
you probably won't
by
get.
The Sand King there. Oh, but he might go down here.
Ace. Take your Zero Strike's available. He does have Trez. He's pretty tanky. He can poop out to his other clone. It looks like he will do so. That means that they've left everybody else here to fight on their own. Rise, Noya. Axe is coming, Boulder Smash comes in. Meanwhile, they do have the invis for empty. It is time to back up now. I don't know if there was any vision of that. They need to head away. They don't want to fight into the RP, especially when Ace is already TP'd home.
Yep, meanwhile on the top lane, Rams, Yuzhen always want to fly pressure this tower.
And it's not going that poorly for friends, you know?
No, not at all.
Radiant
even
structures
at this point.
Are
they
fortified.
Really could use, CMAC could really use a point dagger on both Ace and on Hestio. Vision has scouted him roaming into the lane, so Ramsey's in, always going to fly will back up prematurely. So meanwhile, they get the kill on Baby Knight as he gets caught with what seems to be a Burrow Strike Master Life. RP was also used. So, good positioning as Afterlife and the Ogre rotated in to find that kill. So that Midas down coming out.
Yeah, Ryze was so close to getting the grave off there.
Oh, yeah.
It was like a quarter of a second from getting it off.
That's gotta be frustrating.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
But yeah, that's those BODs minus down. It's gonna help out a lot for friends to stay in this game. Keep pace with this Ace Beepo. That's his god, he's almost got his first Dragon Lance.
Yeah, and friends are actually in a pretty good spot right now though, actually.
Yeah.
Warlock's getting his levels. Their safe lane is pretty much they can't contest anything in that lane right now. Side9 can't do anything with these heroes.
No.
They are trying though now with the Dazzle, Axe, and Earth Spear coming up.
Does he have...
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
He's almost level 8. He's still up here. That might be the perfect time to do so. Rolling Boulder Weave comes out as well. He does have his reincarnation. He has one target. I don't know about this play. The Shadow Word comes out as well. They need another hero top lane. Silence comes through. Afterlife getting ready for a Burrow Strike. He's too far. Raid Fire Blast now. Underneath the tower, Burrow Strike comes out. The grave is there early. Ramses is running. Shadow Word still healing. Finally goes off. And Cloud9 will cover their retreat. So even if they did get that kill, the reincarnation was just skilled up. And then at that point, it becomes nigh impossible to kill him twice.
Yeah, they're definitely glad they did not kill him. They would die.
Which twice?
That would have been rough, for sure.
Just so awkward. You know, you can't go for that guy there. It's hard to catch the Warlock in the jungle. Even if you kill the Warlock once, it doesn't really do anything. You know, it's not like they can translate into anything. They get that one kill and they back up. Afterlife approaching Blink Dagger territory here. 1700 gold for 10 minutes, looking pretty good.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
They're crushing it so far. This Sand King doing very well for himself despite missing out on a couple of kills. But so too, I mean, Hester Joe is going to have his blink at about 100 gold. Not only that, Ace has picked up his Dragon Lance. His blink is now coming pretty soon. And Baby Knight Midas done in a couple CS.
Yep, I'm curious to see what he does once he gets blink on Midas, because I'm not sure he can really fight into their heroes yet. Like, Wraith King has reincarnation, Horlock's sitting in the back behind them. All the other heroes have.
Radiant's
sort of
bottom
AV,
tower
kill
is
Ogre.
Under attack.
I mean, maybe with the axe. They need Noya too, who's now getting Wraith Fire Blast in the top lane. They drop the golem as well. He can rolling Boulder out potentially, and the stun comes through with the Boulder Smash. Shadow Word, there's going to be a heal. Shadow Wave. Ramses now needs to be savaged. There's Wraith Fire Blast. Ryze might have to grave himself. He'll be able to get it off in time, or at least he should be able to. And they're going to get the reincarnation now. But here comes the Ogre. Midnight's rotated in as well. There's the boulder smash. The sounds comes out. The Astral's there as well. Everybody low on mana, including always one fly. The Golem is still chasing. Meanwhile, he misses the call. Now they come in. Afterlife doing work. There's the Epicenter. Grave comes out. There's the Calling Blade. Baby Knight's still alive. Now he wants to go and turn on to always one fly.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Dire's
bottom
tower.
They missed the call. They could have killed Ramses twice if the call hit them.
Yeah, they definitely could have.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Depot's still free farming. He took a tower on his own. Mag took him in tower as well.
More trees. Axe keeping in. No fear needs to leave. I think he's dead. Blink call's ready. There you go. Boulder smash.
You know, he's on level 10. He has the level 1 orb. It does not have very much intelligence. Now, Wraith was losing like 11 and or 11 damage.
Regeneration!
Once he has some more levels than that, he can definitely die before,
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Xanthanese comes out, empty now out of mana. They're gonna have the Earthbind as well. He's gonna fall. Maybe that rotates perfectly and Ace helps get the kill. So, bit too aggressive play coming out from friends there. Losing that hero, very important, as now the blink is up, ready to go for Ace. Great Fire Blast, mid on the Axe. Ramses needs to be careful, Boulder Smash comes out. He could turn on this, but they do have the armlet, so it's tougher to bring him down. Instead, Noah's gonna be the one that's gonna be in trouble, but here comes Baby Knight, the rest of the reinforcements. Astro comes out as the Earthbind is there. Ace looking to go again. The Earthbind potentially jumping in. There's the call. They get it only onto the one, though, but the Burrow Strike encounter is chained. Still, the Warlock is dead. They have the Boulder down. They have the Battle Hunger up. Afterlife falls down, and no fear might be next. Baby Knight diving the tower. Astro will come through. Rises that Shadow Wave, and not only that, but they're going to poop it up. And no fear will give Ace the double kill, and they lose so much out of that. Finally, Cloud9, they can quick dagger from Ace, and boy, they just start going to work.
Yeah, back-to-back exit plays from Cloud9. First the pick on bottom, and then fight.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
But there's no follow-up. He almost has his blade mail. He's a broadsword away from his blade mail at this point. And, well, he can definitely get some kills with that.
Yeah.
I mean, already. The one thing is, they haven't killed Ramses yet, I don't think. Other than when he had his reincarnation. Oh, early in the game they did, but then every other kill has been reincarnation since then. So.
Smoke up from friends now. They have their ultimates up.
This could be a huge kill if they can find Ace. It's easier said than done, but it's a definite possibility. No fear will walk first. And since he's been scouted, that means this smoking is over.
Dire's top
Fire Blast will come
tower
out.
Is under that's attack.
That's they kind of went alone. I don't know why. It was a little strange, but all right.
Yeah, it was more of a smoke just to establish which control. They didn't really, you know, they were
Dire's
really
top tower
there.
Is under attack.
They,
if you're Cloud9, you know that ward's up.
Dire's structures are fortified.
Yeah, of course. Once you see that solo ogre in there, you're like, oh, something's for.
Anyway.
So while they smoked though, Cloud9 was already pushing the top lane in, so they've kind of had like a loss now, right?
Dire's
they're already set up on the tower
under
before
attack.
Friends have even started getting to the tower. Like the bottom tower is at 136 health, and
Radiant's bottom tower
it just
is
took
under
them
attack.
So much longer to take that.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Cloud9 would just surround the top tower. Right?
Radiant's
it will
bottom
take it down
tower
bottom.
Has fallen.
Top is still healthy for the time being. They're TPing some people to the shrine, but they're not TPing anybody in the tower yet. It looks like they're just going to get this away. There. I have to say, by the way, Ramses with
Dire's
Bloodlust and Power
is
kind of ridiculous.
Radiant's
little,
bottom tower
it seems
is under
unfair.
Attack.
It's a great hero to have those buffs on.
Attack's pretty speedy already. Anywho.
Illusion! The bounty which our matriarch will prize.
Don't blame him. Considering the OD in this game, I do not blame him.
Yep.
Ace is going Hex, by the way. He has built an ultimate orb. There's the blade mill done for the Axe.
Very nice.
I
it's a really good way for him to deal with heroes like Mag and Warlock, you know? He can blink in, Hex them.
Yeah.
Axe can call the other.
They have a lot going for them right now, and I think they're waiting on that item in order to start fighting again. They've already picked up the four staff on the OD. He's picked up treads too, which I'm a big fan of, instead of just going ground move. Not only that, but he's not going Hurricane Pike. He's building right into a Wind Dagger after this, which is fair. Oh, baby knight, come on, man. Please, yes. Don't die for it, though. All right, you're good. I get scared sometimes.
Oh, I know what you mean. Well, that's one way to help Raise King farm quickly, right? Bloodlust and a power.
Yeah.
I think this guy will be a monster with farms.
And the funny thing is he still can't even get as nearly as much farm as he can, but that's just because he's a meepo. He went Blade Mail on the Wraith King, by the way, which makes a pretty big amount of sense against meepo. And everybody else, really, the OD included.
Yeah, OD won't want to hit him for too long.
One way to deal with it. At least until... Well, they really can't. I mean, Blade Mail is just, it's very tough in this game to deal with on both sides.
Meepo's actually going to have heads pretty soon, probably before 20 minutes.
Farm.
This hero just farms so fast.
Great hero. Wow, they finally get. Well, I guess he went after Echo Saber first.
Oh, I guess this is the call.
Joey was going for it. There's three heroes up here for both teams. Some pings happening like crazy.
I was meant to have this.
Trying to protect each other, setting up ganks on the side.
Haste! For the treasure!
We've hit the wall where it's a lot of farming right now in this game, but I wouldn't be surprised to see either team make a play when they get their big items.
Yeah, Meepo's holding 700 off his hex.
He was just at 2100 gold. He's already up to 3000 now by his Mystic Staff and then easy pick. However, the smoke coming out from Friends could be a big one. Blink Dagger is now up for the Magnus. Baby Knight is the prime target, it looks like. See if he can get back in time. He's already at the tier 2 tower, but other heroes heading down towards bottom. Anybody been spotted yet? I guess MT is farming bottom. They don't know where the rest of the team is. And so that is a cue for C9 to smoke up heading into the enemy jungle as well. Leave Ace top. However, Baby Knight might get caught mid if he's not careful. And they're kind of pinging him. Ramsey's been revealed. He's been shown. No fear on the backside rise. Big Knight, Rolling Boulder, Noya kind of missing everything. He silences up after that. He takes away. Now the Golem drops as well. Baby Knight, Astrals. Now here comes the Burrow Strike. Axe still in a little bit of trouble here. Always going to apply the Magnetize. Doing some serious work. Rolling Blade might be there. Can he get it off in time? He cannot. The Magnetize is still up. They're going to get two kills here from the side of Frenzy. Now with Baby Knight and the rest of the crew have to leave. Ace is a little too late to the party. Ryze might get jumped on in a moment here. They really want Baby Knight, though. They get the Burrow Strike off. He has the Grave. Can he get it off in time? The Astral will save him. I don't think Ryze can get this, though. It's a little too late. The Shockwave will come out. Ace is going to jump in. Gets the Hex off after. But there's the RP now. Can they bring him down? They have the Empower. This is not the fight they're looking for. Now they get in. The call comes through. And they're going to at least get an extra kill here. Ramp is getting low as well. But again, he has that Reincarnation. Not the best fight coming up from Cloud9. Histojo came back in with a buyback, mind you. Great Fire Blast, looking for more. The upheaval is there. There's the Boulder Smash, which stops it. Ryze gonna have to heal himself. Grave up to 12. Might die and take down to the Shadow Ward. Meanwhile, they get another kill, this time on the Ogre. Actually, and the Axe will fall as well. There's gonna be the Reincarnation. No Rolling Boulder for 10 seconds. Ramses gonna find himself another kill. A strange fight, but it does end up being Friends absolutely crushing it, and Ramsey's getting the majority of those kills.
Oh my god. Ace had his Hex at the very start of the fight there, but he was running to the shop to buy it. He didn't want to fight until he got it, but, oh, Baby Knight catches always want to fly here with the Astral. It looks like he's over there.
Dead hero.
Man, that was so unlucky. Like, the fight started just right when Meepo wanted to buy his Hex. He wanted to go buy his Hex before starting the fight. Then he comes into the fight, and he blows up Thanking, I think it was. With the Hex right away, you know, RP with the Wraith King and Power right click. He's not surviving that.
Ramses is spotted out by the ward, but they won't go for anything yet anyway. We'll see if there's going to be like a smoke or something happening. Ryze nearby. They're going to go for Roche instead, and with the Medallion up, this thing is going to die very quickly. So despite losing a fight there pretty handily, and Friends now having a 1,000 net worth advantage, Roshan will give C9 the Aegis and perhaps give them another go time here for them to try to fight once more.
Yep, good play. They don't have a...
Your son has fallen to the ring.
Immortality!
So free Roshan.
Radiant's bottom
this
tower
Aegis
is under attack.
Might be able to... you know, be enough for Meepo to fight through the ultimate for the next team fight.
Yeah. It's not gonna be easy though.
No. There's so many spells. RP, Epicenter, Rock.
I think we get Ramsey out of the fight early if he doesn't have reincarnation. The fight goes extraordinarily well.
Set up on bottom. Avenite's gotta be careful here.
If he walks up, he might die. I think he's just gonna go with his team now. They're gonna head top. They're gonna take the tier 2 tower, which might signify Ramsey going for the tier 2 themselves down bottom as well. The BKB is the choice for Magnus, which I am not surprised by. Although there's a call in this game, so it's a mind.
Ramsey is so close to the Dark Dagger, they definitely don't want to fight. They're just trying to split the map.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
He's TPing in. Oh, the Hex is up with the Burrow Strike there. It was a bait the entire time. Remember, he has Aegis, though. RP coming out right now. More TPs coming through. It's a long one. The Aegis finally taken out. Now they're going to force forward. Empty Sanity's eclipse. He'll fall. Ramps is going to be next. Magnetize drop along with the Astral. They're looking for. Here comes Dampier City. Counter initiation coming out. The call with perfect timing, though, from Messejo. The Rock is too late to fall. And Cloud9 have already taken two down. But Ramsey's respawns, trying to fight again. The upheaval. Ace trying to micro the best he can. Calling Blade coming out now. The Golem gets asked up, and Ramses will fall yet again. He'll get a kill before going down. It is going to be Ace falling for 77 seconds, but Baby Knight going to work now. They're going to lose all five heroes on the side of Friends. Noya trying to avoid dying to the Golem. What a call from Axe, saving the lives of some of those heroes. And all five get in, they're all just going to back up. Happy with what they've accomplished.
My thanks.
Yep, they're more than just one hero on Cloud9. So. Excellent use of the Aegis there, baiting out all the spells. Makes it so the rest of the heroes on Cloud9 can come in and clean up. So OD is going to be extremely large.
Yeah, Hurricane Pike is going to be done. It's done if he wants it, actually. We'll see, he might just be saving up for something else as well.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Yep, so the Aegis works in two ways, right? It secured them that one fight because they had to use all their ultimates, and now all those ultimates are on cooldown, so they're going to go again right away.
Yeah. As soon as they get this Ace Meepo back up in 22 seconds, he's not even so close to his Ethereal Blade too. I mean, I know it looks like it's like 3,000 away, but it's a Meepo is farmed so fast. Afterlife misses the Burrow Strike on Baby Knight. That should have hit for sure. Still can't find it. He's got his Hurricane Pike now done. The rest of the team is coming. He's going to Astral himself. They don't have RP, and here comes Noya jumping in, looking for a silence. He finds it only on Always Wanna Fly. Everybody backing up, they're here and charge up. Noya in trouble now, getting blown away. The Grave comes out in time. Baby Knight now in trouble. Burrow Strike, they shouldn't fight here. Astral keeps him alive now, but here comes Ace. Ogre Magi will fall first. The Earth Bind plays beautifully. Call onto two. Hestijo with the initiation. Calling Blade not even needed. Ace gets himself a double kill. Good Blink Skewer away from MT. Reverse that order. Meanwhile, Ace finds yet another kill. The back lines to triple kill. And three down, it might be a fourth here as they get the call onto empty. Earthbind is up, they get the Grave off in time. Ultra kill for Ace. And as I had said, he was already not that far away from the Ethereal Blade, and now he's up to 2,000 gold as well. Not only that, four heroes of different friends leads them into potentially getting this tier 2 tower mid.
Yep, Cloud9, great presence of mind. They are playing around these middle tower very, very well. Attack. Afterlife is set up for a Burrow FQ, but I don't think he's gonna go in.
No, I was
surprised. Got no one he can really kill.
But everybody's like full HP too.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
He's gonna have to get back to him. Radiant's top tower is under attack. I think Hestijo and Noya know this. They're like, okay, well, let's not get caught.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
There's also no RP on Magnus now. He's gonna die there.
That's not good.
It could be bad. This might be a later edge.
2-3 will at least fall.
Okay.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
They're just gonna back. They might be able to stop some TPs after like that.
Dire's middle barracks are under attack.
Axe, he might be okay. Blink avoids the ignite. And even with the Blink Burrow, Afterlife is like, well, we can't do anything now. And look at this bait. They're sitting on the high ground ready to go again. I think friends know this. There's a ward nearby that sees it. And sees an ace is nearby. So they know they're not gonna go to the high ground. So that ward actually probably saved their life there. Otherwise, they may go up the high ground and just die.
Oh, nice gameplay from Cloud9 so far. Very, actually, pretty disappointing.
Say hello to my lesser friends.
Seeing they know what they're doing. They've been around the block.
Yeah.
And Ace is Ethereal Blade, by the way.
Jesus, it took like 2.5 minutes to get that.
I know. And from bottom to top, it was like, yeah, like 3 minutes maybe.
All right,
this
so
is kind of dangerous.
There are Meepo illusions in it. He can't poop to those as well.
Oh, this could be a huge kill. Empty is probably shouldn't be here. He's gonna get called along with the creep wave, and he is dead. Long Blade gets the Japanese pass to jail.
This looks like the go-ahead sign to push bottom lane now. 60 seconds, no Magnus. Ace is looking for kills with his Meepo. God, he's almost level 25.
This hero's kind of ridiculous, guys. This is XPM.
Second pick in picking into three massive AoE heroes. Warlock,
he has 1,000. He has 1,000 XPM and 650 GPM.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Because so far, this Meepo gameplay has been very good.
Wow.
Okay. That is a lot of ants.
The answer to that question, it took me a while, but yes, the answer to that question is yes, Brax.
Alright. Now we know.
They've only had one game they've been able to take it in the past 100 games.
Jesus. That's pretty crazy.
Yeah.
Alright, so this is where Friends' lineup gets a little awkward, right? Wraith King is their primary source of physical damage. Magnus does deal some physical damage, but his role is, you know, to RP and everything. Mm. So, Meepo is extremely tanky right now, right? He's got 19 armor, 2300 HP on agility treads.
Mm.
He's getting extremely difficult to kill. And there's also things like Weave armor in fights. Grave doesn't do a whole lot, but just because there's so much AoE. But they do have the counter initiate, right? Noya with the silences and stuns. Axe with the blade call, blade mail and call.
Yeah.
Whew, it's tough to fight into, man.
Yeah, I don't know. They haven't had one good RP yet this game for Magnus, except for on the Meepos, which has just been his job. He's like, okay, you RP the Meepos, and we'll clean up the fight. And it's worked once. The game gets much, much more difficult now because of everything you just talked about.
Looks like they're about to smoke up now.
The Roche is the next objective, probably for both teams. More than likely, C9 gets it easier. Although it is not up for another 3 minutes or so, so it's a pretty long duration Roche respawn. In fact, it's almost full duration Roche respawn, 11 minutes. It's probably a bit frustrating for Cloud9. However, as you mentioned, the smoke looks like it might happen here for a moment. Joe has it, or rather Noya has it, and they're going to group up. No ward to scout this out for the Dire. Until they'll head top. Friends will stick together, but this could be a bad initiation for this Dire squad. Ramsey might get jumped down here if he's not careful.
They don't want to
run forward, and all of a sudden, it becomes much more dangerous. They get the courier, 4K on it. Now they jump in. Bro Strike's only going to find one for now. Baby Knight gets the Astral. There's the Golem. So far, an okay initiation. Now the BKB comes out as well. Noya does drop the Magnetize before dying. Baby Knight almost gets blown away by the Blade Mail. Sanity's comes out. He'll help get the kill. But it's just the Aegis who's having reincarnation. Epicenter getting channeled. Baby Knight's in trouble. Ace, meanwhile, is already cleaning up flat back lines in terms of the Warlock. No Fear is pretty low as well. But Cloud9, I don't know if they could go any further. Like, this might be it. Grave Rise. Probably.
Death cast, no
not
shadow.
Able to TP out. A pretty good fight for Friends there. A lot of abilities used, however, so Cloud9 might not be too disappointed about how that went.
Yeah, very good fight for Friends, actually. The Magnus got blink text by Ace right away at the beginning of the fight.
Mm-hmm.
I was actually surprised. I thought Ace would go back in once the, you know, these heroes all deal damage. There was no power up on the Wraith King. But choosing to play it safe. I mean, they're in control right now. All they have to do is farm the map, get pickoff, wait for Roche, and they...
Well, they can even fight next. I mean, they will have to deal with RP, and reincarnation's already back up, but they will be able to fight with no Golem, no Epicenter next time if they want to go for something here. I wouldn't be shocked if they didn't wait, though, as Roche, as you mentioned, is the next objective, and it's going to be up soon in about a minute or so.
Yeah, Roche is definitely the big key factor here for this Ace is set up in bottom, and Empty might come to farm this lane.
Don't do it, Empty. It's not worth it, my friend. You get hexed, you can't
do
anything. Yeah.
You know, I'll maybe. Take your tribute.
Oh, he's gonna farm this creep wave, and then he's gonna die.
Goodbye.
See you later, buddy.
Lived a good life.
It's nice knowing you. Oh, almost saved him. That came with the first strike. Maybe he's dead now too. He got the root off, but Ace doesn't know who's behind him. It is like, I don't know if I want to go for that. But this gives so much more room for 5-9 again, and he's just gonna bot stop, and they're gonna take the tier 2 tower.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
He's going Scotty next too, and then he becomes really, really difficult to deal.
Dire's top tower is falling. 45 seconds to farm rate equal farm death. Ridiculous.
Yeah.
Roshan is up, and there's no Magnus.
Double damage.
Drop those threats, get that AD. Looking at your Scotty later.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Should be an easy approach. I don't think his friends are in any position to contest this.
This is like the best case scenario for a C9 right
now.
They'll never take us alive!
He's about to finish his Scotty too.
Your Scotty, buddy. Oh yeah, it's 21,150 now, Cole. 4,300 gold. He's got enough to be able to.
Ramses does have 3,300 gold on him though. Curious to see what he buys.
What did he pick up?
Oh, he actually had a BKB on the courier when it died. And he has all that gold on top of him, actually. He's pretty farmed.
He's got some good farm. That BKB's got a lot, too.
They're smoked up. Maybe
this
they can catch
the fight.
They do have
yep. Been caught. Great fire blast. He could play mill off, force away, but he's still going to get fire blast and blown away. Rurikshrek comes out. Ace looking to bring down. Warlock. He's back to Will. Buyback comes out from SKL. Meanwhile, they get the call of the noise, and it comes out north. No fear is about to get destroyed by the orbital bomb from Baby Knight. RP onto 2, however. Now Ramses is coming in. His auto attack damage is going to be pretty good, and now Ace goes right into it. Remember, he has the Aegis to skew out. He wants Empty. He'll find it. Not dead yet. Godlike's free coming out. Now they get the blink call. They'll find Ramses. Again, he has that reincarnation, though. They want to get Afterlife. Aegis is now gone. Ramses will blink out. Ace is a blink ready to go, and he's going to go for him, too. Earthbind comes in, gets off the stun, but here comes the boost. The Hurricane Pike is there. Ramses will fall as the call gets off. And that is a dead kill for 84 seconds until he buys back. Just like that, Cloud9 have put themselves in a very advantage.
Instead
are coming, though, and they want to get this. Okay, that didn't do damage.
Alright, Creep Wave almost killed, but there's range creep.
Like,
unfortunate.
Middle
well,
are under
sometimes
attack.
You just gotta throw it out.
Dire's structures are fortified.
And you just gotta do it so you can survive. Ooh, that Astral was not the best time to make that. Called him first, and now they might have jacked up. Hex is there. We'll be able to get through for an A-Train. Ace is gonna die. On top of the plate now. Now Hesky Joe is left alone. So that might have not been the best play. Boulder Smash comes down, but here to save it. Good golem to be dropped. You still get the kill on Afterlife. Hurricane Pike goes again. No fear will fall. But so too will Baby Knight. They have to drop the gem on the deck. And maybe not the best place from Cloud9. A bit clowny for sure.
Yep. Bringing out some old Cloud9.
That's definitely true. How much damage did they do to this rack? They didn't even do any damage to the range rack, so it's not even permanent damage.
Yeah, the new Wraith King Ultimate. It used to have a 60-second cooldown at max level, now it's 40 seconds.
Oh, it's 40, that's right. I was like, yeah, man, that seems really fast. Up. Forgot about that completely.
Yeah, maybe they need to work on their counting skills. 40 just came up. Tough stuff. No, they didn't think he had reincarnation there.
No, that's... Yeah, I forgot too. I will be honest. Man, I have the ability to look at. I completely forgot.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Well, they will have the Scotty when Meepo respawns.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
That and buyback on top of it.
Yep, they've got about 25 seconds.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
They have a glyph. No, they don't. They have no glyph. This is kind of getting dangerous. The first set of racks could go to friends, believe it or not, if they're not careful.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Ramp's not backing up. Melee Rax is gonna fall here. Yeah, they're gonna lose this. I really
Radiant's
am shocked this is happening.
They do have a shrine ability. Though. He might be able to. Oh. You don't want to port to that shrine blind.
No, right? I don't think so.
That's dangerous.
That is a dangerous play.
Radiant's
they have now
tower
a refresher
is
on the
under
warlock.
Attack.
That's the
he
item
is
man
farmed. That Midas.
That is the item. Yeah, it really is. He's died a lot in these fights too. Friend's really gonna come back in this game. Right now, they're not in a bad position after you're in Arrakis.
No, they're definitely not. Denied. Wraith King's almost hit his 25 as well.
Well, here's the problem though. If the Wraith King dies twice again, he won't have buyback.
Okay,
but that's not
true.
Easy to do. Man. Get your Scotty Ace, you're having buyback. Come on. Maybe he wants to buy something else.
Prioritizing having the buyback for now. Doesn't want to get caught and lose the game. Their base dies so quickly. There's a lot of physical damage on friends right now. Bloodlust and Empower. Arcane Rune on Mag as well.
Writing. MT, now is your time, my friend. This is it right here. This smoke.
Friends spot them out right now. They could be making a move towards them. Smoking up.
This could be huge. Cloud9 could maybe win or lose the game based off this fight. SGO is caught immediately. Needs a save of some sort. Astral, something along those lines. They'll use it aggressively instead. Ace could be in the back line. Hex is now up. He's going to get on empty. Now they drop the golden refresh. He's going to go. Meanwhile, SGO pops the call. So far, nobody's dead. Always want to fly. Can't get off that second ult. No fear's about to fall as well. Grave comes out. They get the kill, though, on the Meepos. Empty pops the RP. And now Baby Knight might be next. Great double call, though. But nobody is alive. Meepo buys back. TP's in. He's got the boost. They need more help, though. Ace is actually pooping away, it looks like, as the epicenter is about to come in. Ramses did not lose a single life there. And Noya is going to be next. The buyback comes early from Ace. But nothing actually comes of it. And always want to fly with the double golem, get the double kill, and still has another golem ready to go after the refresh comes out.
Yeah, in that fight, Ace got on top of the Magnus with the Hex, but he got four-staffed out by the Sand King over the cliff, and he couldn't finish him up. And then once Mag escaped, he came back in with the RP, killed Ace. Man. Friends, they're coming back, man.
Yeah, this is a turnaround if I've ever seen one. The net worth graph is now about 5,000 in favor of Cloud9 instead of the 12,000 it was earlier. And the biggest thing is that they have at least one building advantage in terms of the racks. But yeah, this Warlock Golem, the RP there, Ramses is becoming impossible to deal with. You talked about the AoE in the beginning of the game at the draft. You're absolutely right. That's exactly what they have. And I don't see Cloud9 being able to deal with this. I mean, the thing is, though, they were the ones that got jumped on, right? So,
right.
It's not as if, you know, they're the ones, you know, getting the fights, finding the kills early on in the engagement. If they're the ones making the plays happen for Cloud9, this game maybe gets a bit different.
Yeah, the fight will definitely be better if they can get the initiation for. But a nice word from friends, spots Axe farming the Ancients. They go on first, even though they don't really kill him. They prevent him from getting like the Blademail call off on Wraith King or any other important heroes.
SGO has been on point with his blink calls in this game. They've done so many fights have been very close to just being lost until his blink calls come out. And, it's gonna get harder now as Afterlife is picking up an Aghanim Scepter. The range of the Burrow Strike is going to be nuts. It's gonna be pretty nice. Also, the cost of now. Uh-oh. Noya gets blown away. They are out past the river. They've already lost one. They're gonna lose two. These heroes aren't dead for, you know, 30 seconds. It's 50. They have to keep running. As Baby Knight somehow survives, he has a Hurricane Pike and a Blink. Ace will try to split push. He's gonna send some clones bottom, but this is probably gonna be a full set of racks mid. And perhaps bottom as well. There's no tier 2 or tier 3 power there ready to go.
Baby Knight got jumped by the Wraith King over there. Noya tried to save him, missed the kick, died and against the Ranger.
It's really gonna happen. This is actually gonna happen.
This is happening.
It's looking like it. That Hurricane Pike might do some serious damage to Noya. He's pretty tanky though. He can lose all of his intelligence, whatever.
All these heroes are friends.
Epicenter, RP top lane, Ace, it's a dieback. The rotation comes in and all of a sudden, friends now, they've got the opening to go their way. Baby Knight looking for always one to fly. He has already used his golem. The call is there. Ramses is getting thrown away. Because that Blademail coming out now. But the question is, they kill him twice. The silence comes in, but he BKBs. And now that means a lot of that damage is going to be mitigated. And Axe is going to get absolutely blown away with the Great Fire Blast. Call goes, but he does finish calling. Davey Knight, Sanities will go, but he doesn't have enough damage to bring Ramsey down. The Hurricane Pike, it's not enough. He's so low.
So close.
He's able to get forced out, and now Axe Pie's back, but it's too little too late. So cool, Davey Knight. That means that Ramsey doesn't back away, and they might not lose everything here. Nope, you're trying to get to the low ground, but can't do so. Blink away from both MT and Afterlife. They have the Burrow Strike if they need to get out. They'll drop the gem, sure. But the damage is already done economically for friends in Cloud9.
Man. Radiant's bottom barracks are under attack.
It's not over yet. They did actually end up getting Ramses, by the way. I think it might have been Battle Hunger or something that brought him down, but they did end up getting that kill.
Okay. I think he was poison touched by the thousand.
Yeah, that might have been it too. So full set of racks mid gone, almost full set of racks down bottom gone. And this Meepo has seemed to hit a wall. The Magnus RPs have been what they need. Empty's finding them.
Can't stay alive in these fights anymore.
Yeah.
Not against him. I was meant to have this. He has like this window in the game where he's like extremely strong. You know, he can tank all the damage. It's not that scary, but they do have a small window. Meepo will be up in 25 seconds. Ramses is up in 60. Roshan is up.
Roche. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
They don't know yet, though.
No, they walked out of the pit before it actually spawned. They'll see it now, though.
Okay, checks it out.
Heading to Roche. 13 seconds without Ace. Once they get him, he can just start taking Roche on his own. They need that Aegis, and I think it's Cheese, too. It is, and they really need those. They need both of those at this point. Without those, I don't think they can win a fight. That Warlock's pressure is up. The Golems are up 40 seconds, which means double ulti. Gonna have a look soon. Ace in the pit. And friends aren't making a move, not yet anyway. They're starting to head out inside of the base. 17 seconds without the Wraith. He does have buyback. He's not gonna use it to get through it quicker. They're gonna head up top, deal with the Malusa instead. So they'll let the Roche go. See, not gonna take it. Ace can be grabbed by Ace. I'll put Dragonlance. What? Sense. Trying to buy another Scotty, too, apparently. She's just taken by somebody else. Hester Joe is pretty far away. He needs to leave now, and it's already too late. We might try to fight with this, though. The call comes out. Ramsey's maybe a little too far up front. He's gonna pop from the owner. PKB will go as well. And now with Hester Joe dead for 108 seconds, I don't know if they can do anything here. But if they don't fight now, they might lose the game. RP comes out, hits onto everybody. Burrow Strike, double Golem. Everybody is dead. And I think friends might just win the game here as Ace is now going to get blown away. These Golems and Empty are doing some serious work. They get a double kill to Magnus. And only one person alive. It is Noya. He cannot defend his base on his own. I think this might be game, Brax.
That's looking like it. Oh my god, what a...
What a comeback.
Yeah, back
dear
and
god.
Forth. Haste. Meepo dominating the first 25 minutes of this game. And then it was that one fight where they didn't think Wraith King had his reincarnation of him.
Yeah, they're going to look at that ultimate now and they're going to say, oh, it's 40 seconds.
Okay.
Now they're done. That was such a quick, like, every time. 40 seconds seems to pass so quick.
Right, it feels like it comes up twice in the same fight.